维基解密创办人亚桑杰近日在英国伦敦监狱度过51岁生日。维基解密2010年公布超过50万份与美国在伊拉克和阿富汗战事有关的文件。美国当局以18项罪名通缉维基解密创办人亚桑杰。上个月，英国政府批准将亚桑杰引渡到美国。亚桑杰对此向高等法院提出上诉。曾多次发声要求释放亚桑杰的人权观察组织亚洲区代理总监近日接受中央社专访，他指出亚桑杰健康状况日益恶化，将他引渡到美国违背伦理。
We find the U.S. indictment deeply troubling, and that's because it makes all sorts of standard journalistic practices that are really quite normal in a digital age something that can be criminalized.And so things like taking steps to protect the confidentiality of sources, publishing information that is classified, I think where there is a clear public interest in that, these should not be criminal offenses. And so it really sets a very dangerous and troubling precedent for press freedom, for this indictment and prosecution to go ahead. Well, I think there are real concerns that this extradition, that has just been approved is unethical. And certainly we've seen earlier this month, more than 300 medical practitioners write a letter expressing deep concern about Julian Assange's health, his physical ailments that he suffered. He had a mini stroke last year, as well as the mental health concerns, given the prolonged periods of isolation,And solitary confinement.
皮尔逊也针对近日中国多家党媒引述中国外交部发言人汪文斌的发言，指英美维护的新闻自由是虚伪的镜子，提出看法。
Well, yes, I think it's breathtakingly hypocritical of the Chinese Communist Party to be raising concerns about press freedom when it comes to the case of Julian Assange, when we've seen, you know, numerous Chinese journalists facing lengthy prison terms in really terrible conditions.Also for simply reporting matters that are in the public interest. So I think the Chinese government really likes to pick and choose when it stands up for human rights. I think it is political. And I think, you know, the only time that we see the Chinese government ever using the materials of an organization like Human Rights Watch in a favorable way is when they quote our materials to criticize the US government or the Australian government.
皮尔逊也呼吁美国、英国和澳洲民众应持续关注亚桑杰案及新闻自由，加强施压，持续阻止美国起诉亚桑杰。中央社记者邱德珍，雪梨报道。